Rick Love for the 2013 Sonoma International Film Festival Filmmaker Interview Series here on SVTV 27. In the studio with us, we have a director, co-writer, and actor John Lindstrom and actor Jeff Barry of the film How We Got Away With It, a narrative feature about a group of friends who gather for their annual reunion. One of them's just gotten out of jail, so clearly this is not the Big Chill that we have.
It's been described as a dark Big Chill.
The dark Big Chill, yeah.
Certainly. One of the things that struck me about your film is I spent a year in Rochester, New York, and I found it to be the rainiest and coldest. The words lake effect snow still come up.
So did we, and we shot in August.
You make it look beautiful. I mean, Rochester has never looked better than it does in your film.
This actually was really important to me because I grew up there. That's mm-hmm. all my family's properties that you see
that
in the
lake
film.
Lake Ontario?
Yep, right on the lake. But there's been a few movies made in Rochester, and they're dark, they're mm-hmm. gray, they're industrial, and I grew up there. It's a beautiful town. And so that was one of the things for me in the back of my head. I wanted to create something that captures the beauty of it because it really is, in the summer, a lovely place. So thank you.
Absolutely, yeah. It's almost like a character in the film. Your setting there and the home, and that's such an important part.
The house and the lake are actually treated as two separate characters, almost polar opposites, actually. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It's interesting because you have a character who's just gotten out of jail. So he's had his shot at redemption, but his redemption doesn't really last very long, does it?
Well, yeah. I mean, it's the film is essentially a film about abuse and how we deal with it, and you know. But I'm even a little reticent to use that particular word or bullying because I think it's a little general. But if there's only one word I could use to describe, it's really a coup. Henry, the lead character that you mentioned, basically stages a coup, and he enlists someone to help him do that. Interestingly, it's who he picks to help him to do that, and not somebody else in this group, which happens to be their annual summer weekend reunion with all the friends that they've known either since they were children or when they picked up in college. The tagline is, a young man and his friends react violently to an unexpected tragedy on the eve of their weekend reunion. There is a bit of a search of redemption, or what he believes is redemption, really revenge, mm-hmm. which he thinks is going to lead him to redemption. And then, of course, there's the built-in irony of the title,
How We Got Away With It. Certainly. Well, and it's because that's set up, and because it's the title going in, there is kind of this undercurrent where even when everyone's smiling and happy, there's a feeling of like almost violence that comes through.
Yeah, there is. I think that's one of the reasons I use the word coup, because there is a tyrant involved, even though he's a small town version of a Muammar Gaddafi. He is a tyrant. And when you live in that kind of an environment, and especially one where there's abuse involved, there's a facade of lies, and there's a culture of denial that builds up. And so one of the things that we were very careful about when we wrote the script was not to be forced into using pedantic dialogue to describe and inform everyone, but to try to tell the story through the character's behavior, right. Whether or not they knew something or didn't know it, if they did something about it or they didn't, whether they live in denial about it, which is one of the themes of the movie as well.
And so underneath those smiles that you see, there's layers going on given what has happened, what they know and what the group may or may not know.
Secrets, manipulation,
constantly
going on. And you know, you can sense that these people are all ready to kind of blow up and go away from each other already. Mm-hmm. And what happens on this weekend, you know, could certainly prove to do that.
And what struck me is you have this beautiful setting and all of these very beautiful people, yet it's not, what's happening there is not pretty in any way, and that's kind of an undercurrent as well. And that extends to not just your casting, but also the way it's shot. It's shot in a very pretty, I mean, you could take stills from this movie and say, you know, that's an ad for Rochester tourism.
thank you.
Yet the narrative going through the through line is dark, as you said.
It is dark and it's tense. I've talked to people who watch the movie and I see their feet starting to move around, and I say, what's the matter, are you bored? And they'll say, no, I'm nervous.
Uncomfortable.
I'm really uncomfortable about this. And I go, really, we're only in the touch football game. Mm-hmm. there is a lot of very fresh and relatable humor, character humor, that infuses the film and makes these people much easier to be around. Mm-hmm. You know, they are friends, they began as friends. So finding that layer of tension that lies underneath it was really a kudo to all the actors. Most of them unknown, but incredibly talented. I mean, we were lucky enough to create a great ensemble that knew how to work together.
Mm-hmm. But in the original, in the Inception, that juxtaposition between the beauty of what you see, the fun of the daytime, and then the violence and what they pursue at night, the two of those things clashing with each other, it makes the story, and I think is really a unique part of the story.
Certainly, and it just forces you to never take at face value what you're seeing.
Absolutely.
On the screen.
Right. Absolutely.
My wife would kill me if I didn't point out your previous work.
Good.
Knew it was going to be there. We saw you at a screening last night, and she was like, oh, I loved him on General Hospital in Port Charles. You cast yourself in the film. Was there any concern about that, about having a, because you're playing the detective who comes in and kind of like...
Yeah, is kind of the conscience of the story in mm-hmm. a way. And was there any hesitancy? Not really. We had an actor who was cast, and he had to fall out. Uh-huh. And being the director and co-writer and co-producer, I didn't really have a lot of time to think about it. I just said, I know how to do this. I'll just cast myself, and I won't fall out.
You'll be there.
I'll right. be yeah. there the whole shoot. So, I mean, that was really just the thinking behind it. It was my lady, an actress named Katie McLean, who happens to be on All My Children right now. She was the one who gave me the idea, because I really just didn't want to act in it. Not because I thought there would be some negative association with soap operas, mm-hmm. Simply because it was my first feature and I didn't want to distract myself.
But right.
Jeff would take over essentially the directing duties while I was in front of the camera. So that, once we were able to agree on a process of how to get there, it was really very simple to do.
And when you're shooting outdoors, it's not like you can go sit and in front of the monitor and look at take
not
after
on our
take.
Budget,
you got to get you got to get going.
We didn't have time for that.
We didn't have
either.
Time. Yeah.
So you just kind of trust yourself that if he's looking at the monitor, that he got it and you got it, and then you can just move on.
Well, Jeff has also made short films. I mean, both of us had made short films. We worked together as a writer on this particular project. So, I mean, I'd seen his work. I knew he knew what he was doing. Mm-hmm. And we had also the DP and I, Michael Belcher, had very carefully decided on how we were going to compose the shots. And that's one reason they look so good. Mm-hmm. But they have a certain kind of tension and feeling about them. And so Jeff was just able to, we'd already established a template, Jeff was able to just carry it on and keep it going.
And I think that was an extension of a very collaborative set. You know, we across the board, we hired people for them to do their jobs. We were fortunate to hire the right people, and as a result, it was very open, and it's about the best idea in the room.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm sorry I dissed Rochester, but thank you very much.
Yeah.
And you didn't diss soap operas either.
That's
true.
You've
got to pay for this stuff somehow.
The film is How We Got Away With It. We have director, co-writer, and actor John Lindstrom and actor Jeff Barry. Thank you very much for coming in, talking to us on SVTV 27's Filmmaker Interview Series here at the 2013 Sonoma International Film Festival.